on where we wanted to go. We wanted to do something that was close, but also something that was kind of a big deal. And the Sally House was the perfect distance for us to get out to.
You load up the parrot again.
I didn't really know what to expect when I got there.
That was the third time before I got the video going.
Pictures of it online, but didn't really know a ton of detail.
I thought you guys quit doing it at 5 p.m.
It reminded me of the house I grew up in. I grew up in a really old house, and it has that same vibe of like a house that's
seen a lot. It's got to be some kind of meaning to it, symbolic meaning. I don't know what it is.
We turned on some music. We did a little dance, trying to like stir things up.
We light up a cat ball. I think that's the only thing else I have on. You light up a cat ball?
I would say mostly.
The one by the little cactus pot there, the white one.
This is one of the, like, honestly most interesting, like, I guess I was like crazy.
You see the cactus pot by the bear with the
white.
Just nodding off before you guys woke me up.
Would like bounce off the stairs and come back. And then we threw it into the room. And then after like went in like all the way into the room and there was like a pause. Like it was in there for a second. And then it came back out full speed.
I had the cat ball on the cactus pot, the white one.
Three of us just trying to recreate what happened. But we started doing an EVP session in there. And we had an EMF detector sitting up on the bed, you know, propped up pretty sturdily. And as we were starting to get, you know, into the EVP session, we asked it to move something, and the EMF detector falls over on the bed.
We were on the tail end of a 10-night haunted road trip with Richard S. Depp with his book, Great American Ghost Trip. And Sally House was supposed to be...
You keep hearing little noises, too. Like, I don't know what that is.
So, what happened next is everyone kind of dispersed and went to... we were on the living room floor, so Robin was another investigator on the trip, and then...
Come on, light up the cat ball on the cactus pot.
Right at the top of the stairs, and it starts... going off. So we started, of course, trying to engage in. It wasn't until after the fact of engaging with the REM that a viewer, someone on my page who had seen it, said, "You don't see the mist." And I had to go back, and you see it's things, but there is a white mist that goes from right.
Sorry, I'm nodding off here. Come on, light up a cat ball, please, whoever you are. I don't have my other equipment on other than the parrot. Like I said, I thought you guys quit making the parrot talk at 5. Light up a cat ball. A couple under the table, too.
Separate parts of the house. I went into the basement with one of the investigators, and she's just like all, she's spun up. She's very high spirit.
Light up a cat ball if you want me to do a spirit box session later tonight.
So
it'll probably be late tonight. Cause
and whatnot. I'm like, I'm not impressed.
Got some stuff I gotta do.
What really happened to me at that house that was like earth shattering or of interest? Everything was happening to our females that evening. So we go to wrap up. So that alleyway, kind of on the north side of...
Are you done lighting up the parrot now?
You park down there where you're on the nursery side. And I go back in because the code's still the same. It hasn't changed. Nobody else is up at the house at this point.
3 in the morning.
I open the door, and the first thing I hear is another door slam.
You light the parrot one more time, one last hurrah.
The basement door was open, bathroom door was closed, every door was locked to the external, so it wasn't a person who slammed the door. I still don't know what door slammed. Grab my drink, turn off the lights as I'm going out, I get to the front door, turn off the main light, and the kitchen light turns back on.
Did you say the man light?
I'm like, okay, cool. Walk back over.
The main light.
And quickly exit the house. And explain to Aaron, hey, this is what just happened.
So I asked him why he went upstairs.
Which I did not.
Because I saw the light in the hallway, the hall stairs go on. But then it turned off really quickly. And I'm like, okay, well, did you hit a light?
Any cat balls you could light up really quick, please?
So we are here in one of America's most haunted houses. We are at the Sally House. Are you excited for tonight's investigation?
I'm really excited for tonight's investigation. I've heard so many stories about this place. A lot of the stories revolve around...
I watched the Sally House episode there. It was boring. I didn't get anything.
What I want to personally is not focus on the dark side of this house. I want to focus on trying to communicate with Sally. It's important to remember that...
Okie doke. Guess you're not going to light up a cat ball.
It could just be a story. But if she doesn't exist, there is a theory that a lot of people believe that say that if enough people tell a story over and over and over again, and